Hello and welcome to Facing Off and to week 27 of the Elite Ice Hockey League. As always, we've got loads of goals and some exciting games to look forward to over the next hour, with plenty of big hits and top plays from all around the league. So here's how the league table looked at the start of week 27. Cardiff sits 7 points clear at the top of the pile, as well as Challenge Cup champions, leaving Belfast and Sheffield with plenty to do below them. The Steelers will be looking for a positive response after their defeat at Ice Arena Wales in the Challenge Cup final, while Belfast will still believe that the Devils can be caught. The fight for the top eight continues, with Manchester and Dundee looking to suck Coventry right into trouble as the playoff battle intensifies at the bottom. We start this week, though, at the SSE Arena in Belfast, where the Giants entertain the Panthers on Friday night.
And there's a foot race here. Brian McGrattan breaking down this right side, gets the top of the circle, winds up, good shot, and an equally good save by Stephen Murphy. Far side and McGrattan battle for it, but that's a great defensive play, and here come the Giants, 3-on-2 chance. Colin Shields down the right side, chance to throw it out front, comes off the skate of a Panther, and they head the other way, this time through Brian McGrattan. McGrattan spins back towards the blue line, lays it off for Schultz, my apologies. Saviano doing a good job defensively there. Schultz and Saviano battle for it. Derek Walls are in the collector. Rister comes right out front and goes through the feet this time of Brian McGrattan. Demaray winds the shot up. Top corner shot. First goal of the game. Still at Belfast Giants. Goes to James Demaray. 9:26 to go in the first. Still at Belfast Giants 1. Nottingham Panthers 0. Kept in at the blue line, knocked out of the air this time by Schultz. Garside there to help out, but Martinelli reads that well. And again, put under immediate pressure. Cross ice pass to Mike Quinnell. Here comes James Demaray, the goal scorer. Gets the blue line. There's an inside for Quinnell. Steps in. Lovely play again. Mike Quinnell puts the Giants 2-0 up. Vickman. That didn't look as if it was a. The most bodies in front, but it did look as from our angle. Didn't look as if it was a hard shot coming through there either, Johnny, but he puts the Giants 2-0 up with 7:31 to go. Good battle here, but Sarkanis again, good positioning. Gets it back to the blue line, kept in by Lee Betteridge. Behind the net for Lakovitz. Good read that time by Leduc. And Saviano, a little lovely little backhand pass there to Colin Shields. Saviano heading towards the net, tips it in front and looking to get the second effort there as Colin Shields gets it back to the blue line. Leduc keeps it in, winds up, takes a shot. Good save by Vickman. Martinelli now throws that towards the net, tipped in front, and it looks as if Colin Shields, no, he's pointing around Martinelli. Colin Shields, thereabouts, and a third goal for the Stanley Belfast Giants. Jerome Leduc into the corner again for Blair Riley. Good play here by the Giants, keeping around the outside, but the Panthers trying to put the pressure on them. Breaks there for Van der Meer, and again out back at the neutral zone. There's a chance here for McMillan breaking forward. There's going to be a penalty on the play, though. And the Panthers have got a shorthanded goal. A puck bobbling there into the path of Jim Van der Meer. The big man just couldn't control it. And the Panthers off and running with a shorthanded goal.
Yeah, that was a really nice goal by Larry. He's a prolific goal scorer, and he was a big part of their team last year winning the championship. But he's a good guy, he's a good goal scorer, and that was, yep.
Oh, lovely goal. Tipped there by David Rutherford. But great vision coming out from behind the net. David Rutherford, lovely slap pass coming in from Derek Walzer. And a quick power play effort puts the Giants back in lead with a 3-goal lead. And he's the in the high slot. And no man going towards the front line. Is that an opportunity for putting the likes of, you know, the best guy tipping the puck in front that I've seen this year for the Giants in practice is Jim Van der Meer. The guy's unbelievable in front of the net tipping.
Yeah, he's great. He's always...
Great save there by Stephen Murr, by Mika Vickman. It's eventually made its way into the net. Just as they come back, the penalty was over for Brian McGrattan. I'm not too sure he got the final touch on the Colin Shields.
Yeah. 2-0-2.
Giants back on their own end here. Nickerson being put under pressure. Lovely pass ahead, but gets a little drop pass for Blair Riley. Walzer feeds it through to Forney, but goes a little bit too far ahead of him. Lindhagen has to retreat. Again, the Panthers just can't get the tape or the puck going tape to tape. Nickerson being put under pressure, a little nudge ahead there. It's a good read, lovely pass out front But a good read again from Derek Walder. Chris Higgins now steps it past him. And he's got a helper coming in at the back door through Blair Riley. A lovely pass by Riley. One-time effort. Second effort. Blair Riley gets the sixth goal of the evening for the Stenline Belfast Giants. And it looks as if Dan Green has just been told to get his helmet on. Nikovic might be coming off the ice. Staviano now. There's a lovely move inside. Pass across. Shot coming in. Oh. Colin Shales. Hat-trick goal. 204 for Colin Shales. But a great play by Steve Saviano to set that goal up. Around the horn, kept in at the blue line once again. This is better play from the Panthers. The shot there comes in, but goes wide of the target. Ends up in the stick of Nikiforuk again behind the bench. And you could maybe go for a holding the stick call there, but Dean Smith, the referee, lets play continue. Shot coming in, blocked in front. David Rutherford collects one there now to the nether regions. Another shot coming in. Good blocker save. Second effort. And a second goal for Chris Lawrence. Great play, but just commented there about the you know, it was a really good shift for the Nottingham Panthers. David Rutherford there counting them as he's skating off. But that's got to hurt. And the Panthers pick up their second goal of the evening, Johnny. Sarkanis looking to get the Jets going there, but great poke check by Jim Vandermeer. Demarai tries to make a move around him. Again, Sarkanis got the wheels going. Spang's heading towards the net. Feeds him in front. Good save. Oh, what a save. Oh, they went in.
Goal, yeah.
Top corner. I thought Stephen Murphy had the puck there, but it's a great finish by Dan Spang. 4-on-4. And a great play there by the Nottingham Panthers.
Coventry were hoping that their penultimate home game of the regular season could bear fruit. They welcomed Fife to the Sky Dome on Saturday.
The crazy crew, please, now go to the open end of the arena. Thank you.
It's Bergman with a fake handoff. Will dipsy doodle himself down. Lowe sends it right out in front, and it's there. And the Flyers have dealt with it pretty well, actually. After it fell under the feet of Brooks, who couldn't take the puck, and Dingle jumps around Jim Jorgensen, hard backhand, caught Stewart by surprise, but caught the line change unaware as well, as Robinson's hit the trailer nicely, chance, and it's finished off fantastically by Venus.
What a take from, but what a pass from Brett Robinson there, who finds Ross Venus, who comes in. He's completely unchallenged. He's still got some work to do there, though, because not only is Shane Owen in front of him, but there's also a Fife Flyers defenceman down on the ice. And he's got to find the gap between the two of them to get that puck in.
Had to blow down a couple of rough moments, a couple of trips, a couple of hooks. All in all, I think he managed the first period fairly well, although it always looked like it was going to boil over. It might boil over here for Dingle. It does. That is an absolutely superb finish. Right upstairs, right in that little kind of 5x5 gap over the glove hand. Talk about boiling over. This erupted over the netminder. Holding up, and TJ Seiner will use his speed, leaves it off around Maeda. Maeda gets into the corner. Seiner, Marquard will head to the net front. Seiner back to looking for Almeida, just away from the toe of his stick. That puck gets right between Godfrey and Dingle, and Dingle's won it. Dingle tried to lay it across. Oh, it's redirected in. An awkward bounce. Give up a 2-on-1, and the Fife Flyers have taken a lead shorthanded. And Bergman will still get this behind the net. Robin Bergman's really been, aside from a couple of giveaways in the second, the best player tonight. Oh, but that's a big giveaway. Oh, my goodness. Finucci 1-on-1 with Stewart. 3-1 Fife.
Gets the turnover from Bergman and then just breaks clean in through. Finucci's that type of a goal scorer. He's not going to miss those one-on-one opportunities against the netminder. Breaks. It's got a lot of wheels there. Comes out with speed.
35 seconds remaining of power play for the Blaze. Well, it's advantage Fife, but that's a great stretch pass. Robinson, big save. Oh, but the rebound's put home. The Blaze hopes of getting anything tonight have just been extended by Brett Robinson. first one, the door was slammed, but it left a crack, and he crept in like a thief in the night. Sina, I'm not sure what that was, but the Five Flyers have jumped on it. Siska, back out to the back door, Dingle. It came off the skate of, I think, Noble, who was diving. And now Marquard, with 10 minutes left in the game, is going to go towards the net. Marquard bumps through Haynes, still has possession. Flicks it in behind. Almeida's there. Almeida might get away from Paquette here. He has. He's wrapped it around in front. Oh, it's in. It's tucked in. It's Sean Boutin. That's the moment the Blades were waiting for. It's a 3-3 hockey game. And Sean Boutin, Johnny on the spot, has given the Blades a real good run at this one. It's fourth of the season, and he won't score one more important. Here come the Blades. It's Barry Almeida off for Sina. Sina down to Jorgensen. Big chance plays. Oh, it got away from Jorgensen. Siska did enough to disrupt the American, who's drifted to the top. Leaves it down, and Finucci will say thank you very much. But TJ Sina's picked that up with some help from Almeida. Sina! Oh, he guides it wide. Cheeky play from the little guy. Now Siska. Oh, he's fed Finucci. Another breakaway for Carlo Finucci. And another goal for Carlo Finucci. All she wrote. The Flyers taking an OT. Carlo Finucci played in the EPL last year. Why? After a good year in Denmark? I don't know. And there, his two goals have been enough.
Sheffield headed to Brayhead knowing nothing less than 2 points would be enough to keep their fading title hopes alive for at least another night.
Carlson.
Steelers look to move it forward quickly. It's Levi Nelson, 76, plays it across. Koski just moves it on. Sullivan is helping out. It's enforced back the way. It's down with the second one. Swept it in, one timer. Levi Nelson working well. Teed it up for Robert Dowd. Dowd one timed it into the net. Zajkowski beaten. The Steelers have taken the lead. It's coming off the plexi, and it's Valdix to Nelson. Inside to Dowd. That's a good finish. Nelson and Dowd combining there. You have to say that's an excellent finish from Steelers number 75, Dowd, his second of the game. Nelson dinked it on for Dowd. Dowd just looked up, saw the spot he wanted to aim it to, and there it is, 3-1 Steelers. Carlson has to change it. Cowick back on the ice. Clan have a power play for just over a minute. 5-on-4 opportunity. They've already scored a power play goal tonight. Second one wouldn't go amiss. Save from Mustakov. Peacock sends it over. The initial shot from De La Rovere, forcing Mustakov into a save. Peacock couldn't keep his rebound effort down. Carlson flashes in again. That's got the fans onside. Levitt. Levitt Looks up, takes a touch. Taylor O'Bear.
Or was it Matt Keith? I think it was Matt Keith. Another redirect into the Steelers' goal. Sent in by Levitt. Taylor O'Bear with a touch. It looked like Matt Keith with the final touch. And it's 2-3.
It would be a much needed morale booster getting into their home game with Cardiff tomorrow. Debian tries on the empty net. Zykowski's pulled, as you can see. One last push from the clan. It's Wharton. Lumped by Coyle. Keller over. Looking hard. Levitt. Levitt has it. Dramatic stuff. This is what the Elite League is all about. Becker. Is this a chance? It's Levitt. Tees up Pitt. Doesn't quite get contact on the shot. The stick breaks at the crucial time. Taylor O'Bear. He's done it, or has he? Has the puck gone in? It has! My goodness, 5 seconds to go. Taylor O'Bear has managed to squeeze the puck in, or has he? We're getting a bit of debate here. The officials watching it very closely. What is the verdict going to be? It looked very tight. What is the decision? Did it go in or did it not? There's a timeout here.
Time for a dizzy fish. Time out.
Nope, the goal hasn't been given. Well, dramatic stuff there. We thought the puck had been squeezed in at the near post by Deller Over. It hadn't made it.
Still to come, after the break, we'll look at all the rest of Saturday's fixtures from around the Elite League. League leaders Cardiff were trying to take another step towards their first league title since 1997 when they welcomed Dundee to Ice Arena Wales on Saturday night.
Play. Scott Hoffman collects that. Back on play, and it's Doucette there. It's going to be another penalty. It's going to be a trip.
Got to get this on net, though. No stick for Fallon.
Martin down low. Ulmer's fishing around the crease, but Fallon does well to cut out the pass. Down, and Fallon makes the save. It's loose, and the Stars get it away. Andrew Hotham. Another save from Fallon. It's still loose. Richardson was there trying to put it away. 40 seconds remain on the power play. In behind. Fanned on it by Lane Ulmer. And again, he's getting himself in those positions.
Draw won by the Cardiff Devils again, who are good in that area. They get it back to Mark Richardson now with space. Shoots. Good save. It's there. Oh, they score. Deflected in. The Devils go 1-0 up. Joey Martin, Bentivoglio gets it in deep, but there's time for more there on the far side to clear, which he does, and does very well indeed to Kale Tanaka on the break up against Mark Richardson. Tanaka around the outside, might be a chance. They think they scored, the buzzer's on, it's given. Short-handed goal, Kale Tanaka makes it 1-1.
A messy goal for the Cardiff Devils to concede a shorthanded goal, but credit to the Dundee Stars to be offensively aggressive on the penalty kill like that. And Kale Tanaka, we know, has got such a strong skating stride.
Good strong play from Lane Ulmer. Back to the point where Mark Richardson has it. Over to Andrew Hotham. Andrew looks to make a move, goes back to Mark Richardson. Through traffic, tipped out front, still there on the doorstep. What a save, now they score! Joey Haddad makes it 2-1 Devils in the second.
Bit of volumes there, pad save, once, twice. Martin. Play into Bendavolio. Ulmer's sniffing for that puck as well. Now Andrew Hotham, and now it's into Fallon's glove, and there's a siege on his net at the moment. 50 seconds left on the power play. Aslin tries to find it back door, and that's cleared by the Stars. Only a few seconds left. That's a lovely stretch pass by Bounds. Haddad, and it's there! What a slap shot from that man again! Joey Haddad from a long stretch pass from Ben Bounds, and the Devils have some breathing room. 3-1.
It does. We did talk about these four lines up against three and question whether fatigue might come into it with the pace the Stars played with in the first. And
Josh Barts, what a goal! You know you've got it, he's got it in his locker. But once again, the stick-handling ability of the big defenseman is there for all to see. And it's a wicked wrister that flies past Fallon. 4-1, Cardiff Devils.
As the Red Army chant goes round, Tanaka tries to get a consolation here at the end, but gentlemen, two more wins will do it for the Cardiff Devils. That will go down to one should the Belfast Giants lose any games between now and the 25th and 26th of March.
It's tantalisingly close to the Cardiff Devils, probably as close as it's been in 20 years. And I know the three of us here in this gantry, we hope everyone at home knows we call the games as neutral as we can, but it comes as no shock to anybody that we're all long-standing Cardiff Devils fans. And if our excitement levels are anything like the excitement levels of the other 3,000 people in this building, the Cardiff Devils are about to make some history, perhaps, in their 30th season. And as you referenced earlier, Gaz, 20 years since the fourth league title they won. It's very much the drive for five, and it's very much on right now.
This was a huge weekend for Manchester Storm, who lost eight straight prior to the visit of Edinburgh Capitals, who are themselves in last chance saloon if they're to make the playoffs.
Huge weekend coming up here for the Manchester Storm. Jared Stahl now putting Trevor Johnson under a lot of pressure, but the Storm captain comes away with it. Been put under pressure though is Bissonnette. Great forecheck here from the Edinburgh Capitals. Dallas Earhart puts the brakes on and finds Matt Bissonnette. Lays that into Taylor Dickin, but doesn't take control of the puck very well. A bit scrappy here from the Storm, but as I say, great forecheck from the Edinburgh Capitals, putting the Storm under a lot of pressure. But Cody Carche now has an opportunity, throws it right across, but Dickin doesn't have the stick down on the ice. And it rebounds off his skates. Dzinski now for the Storm, finds Varley, first year pro, straight out of Penn State University. Throws it right across, and it's a goal for the Manchester Storm. Connor Varley throws the puck in on goal. It's the Manchester Storm 1, the Edinburgh Capitals 0. Chance here now. Stahl gains his zone. Throws that in on Clement. Deals with it well. Forward comes Carche now. Chance of a 3-on-2 if Carche gains his zone. And he does gain his own chance here now. Throwing in on Fullerton. Doesn't know where it is. And it's a goal for the Manchester Storm. Great play from Cody Carche. Manchester Storm 2, the Edinburgh Capitals 0.
Crowd are getting noisy now. They know that they've got to make the difference. The only two things that we've written on the game sheet for this period are two penalties against Storm. And that's exactly the game plan, well, that Pasha didn't want if he had to write history.
It's been a period dominated by the Caps. Durazio now. Johnson, this one go. Good save from Mike Clement. And excellent instinctive save. That 5-on-3 kill was huge for the Storm. Now puck just comes out of the zone. Swindlehurst will give chase, putting Durazio under a bit of pressure there. Heavy on the forecheck. Swindlehurst finishes his hit as well. As we've mentioned a couple of times, he's been playing forward for the last while and he's done very well in that position as well. Fedorov now gains his zone again. Battling with Pasha. Pasha comes away with the puck. Lays that off to his D partner, Varley. Throws along the line to Swindlehurst. Swindlehurst, lovely pass to Heatley. There's a chance. Heatley through the five hole! Great play there from Connor Varley. Lays it into Mark Heatley. It's the Manchester Storm 3, the Edinburgh Capitals 0. Claire, you just throw it out there. You're not into superstitions. Oh, turnover here. Dzinski. Will he pick up that hat trick? But he does! Pick up that hat trick! What a finish from Double D, Darren Dzinski. And with 1:16 to go here at the Storm Shelter, it's a Manchester Storm 4, the Edinburgh Capitals 0. And that is a wrap here at the Storm Shelter. Paul Phillips and Mike Clemente. Very happy goaltender, very happy defenseman, very happy team. Coach Pasha and all the guys jumping in there into the huddle. A convincing victory in the end for this Manchester Storm team.
And still to come after the break, we'll catch up on all of Sunday's fixtures in the Elite League. Second-placed Belfast take on Urquhart Conference rivals Nottingham for the second time this weekend, following Friday night's 7-3 victory against the Panthers at the SSE Arena.
Shout out to Michael Hoy. Oh, and there's going to be a scrap here. Quinnell and Nikiforuk, two lightweights, middleweights. Nikiforuk feeding Quinnell a couple of rights. Quinnell coming back with it. This is a good scrap from two small guys. Real battle here. Not too sure what started that out, and both of them are quite happy with the way things go. And getting things off to a feisty start. Quinnell heading down the changing room for repairs. There, Riley, he decides to go around the wall. Riley picks it up in the corner. This is great penalty killing by the Giants under pressure by Blair Riley. Takes a shoulder there from Lindhagen, and Sertic goes behind the net. And a lovely pass through the middle for Brown. It's tipped off Brown, but collected by Lindhagen. Giants back to 5-on-5. Lindhagen decides to put the brakes on the circle. Brown shot through, and they take the first goal of this game on a Sunday afternoon. It's an even strength goal, and Jeff Brown, I believe, will get the credit. But Lindhagen doing all the hard work. 13-11 to go in this first period. The Nottingham Panthers 1, Stenline Belfast Giants 0.
You were talking about wanting to do some power play time this year. You get a bit jealous when Adam Keefe is on the power play on Friday night.
Yeah. We got one power play shift last year, and Mitch Ganzak ruined it for us. I won the face off back to him, and then he passed it in Darrell's feet. And then the puck went out, and we never got a chance again. So.
The Giants back in their own end now. Nickerson nudges it ahead to Rutherford. He sidestep Nikiforuk. Rutherford, big miss shot there.
What a shot!
Wow. What an absolute bullet from David Rutherford. And we've got a tie game. 15-14 to go in the second period. Stenline Belfast Giants 1, Nottingham Panthers 1. Coming out this right side. The Panthers trying to break through the middle there. It's a foot race as Lindhagen battles Leduc for the pocket. Takes a hit from Jeff Brown. Demarai, lovely pass down this right side, and got Saviano breaking for the shot there.
Yes. Oh, what a goal.
Great shot from Colin Shields. It took a deflection off the defenseman's stick, I believe, but went into the top corner, the same corner that David Rutherford got the first. And the Belfast Giants have came from one down to lead 2-1 with 8:17 to go in the second period. Walzer goes D to Z. Matt Nickerson now. Oh. He slapped past there to Sarkanis. He thought that guy was wearing a teal jersey, and the Panthers now have a chance to head the other way. Lakovic gets it across ice, doesn't find a white jersey again, but here comes James Demarai. Desi makes one move, sidesteps again, looking to use his body, protect the puck, gets it out front, shot again, hit the crossbar, deep by Leppard, and the Belfast Giants have scored the third goal of the evening. David Rutherford gets his first opportunity, hit the crossbar, bounce right down. Mika Vickman thought he was broken. Oh, high five. Yeah. Mika Vickman thought he was beat already. Didn't react to it. And David Rutherford takes a second effort and puts it past Vickman for a 3-1 lead to the Stenline Belfast Giants.
Real battle here down in front, kept in at the blue line by David Clark. Stevie Lee goes cross ice to Sarkanis. Big challenge, a big hit there between Lawrence and Martinelli. And here comes a lovely move around there. Blair Reddy steps inside. He scores a shorthanded goal. Great work by Blair Reddy, but by the whole unit of Derek Walzer, Martinelli. I think it was Mike Forney that needed to pass up the wall. But great skill shown by Blair Reddy. And Blair Reddy puts the Giants 4-1 up with 6:45 to go.
Now the Panthers are still on the PP here for the next 1 minute and 19 seconds as Matt Nickerson sits in the penalty box. Nikiforuk on the puck at the half wall. Okay, and the Giants box is really closing in here. Shot coming in. Oh, what a shot from an awkward angle. And Dan Spang with a wrister puts it up high past Stephen Murphy with a power play goal. And that is now 4-2 to the Stenline Belfast Giants. And Vickman comes out to play it around the wall again. Comes off the back of the net there. Need to be very careful. Saviano putting the pressure on. Rutherford and Clark combined to collide into the corner. Here comes James Demarai stepping out from the corner. Looks to make it in front. A lovely private James Demarai. David Rutherford with a hat trick here this evening at the SSE Arena. But what a pass from James Demarai. Vickman really not happy. He's throwing the stick off the crossbar.
And a great play by James Demarai finds David Rutherford with that hat-trick goal with 5:30 to go in this third period.
League leaders Cardiff renewed their bitter rivalry with Sheffield on Sunday night when Andrew Lord's side travelled to South Yorkshire just 7 days after beating the Steelers to win the Challenge Cup.
Now Ratcher, Dowd and Nelson combining. Steelers into the offensive zone. This is where they're dangerous. Oh, and a touch from bounds takes it away to deny Valdix. Valdix again. Passes in towards Nelson and the shot gets deflected off target. And bounds not called upon this time. The Steelers are starting to pick up the tempo and the intensity. Valdix, big chance here. Oh, over the top from Ratchuk. And then hammered in from Dowd. He's at it again. Robert Dowd just can't stop scoring. And the Sheffield Steelers have the opener after they've been building pressure for a few shifts. Put in! Mustakovs was scrambling and Lord reacted first and sweeps it home for the equaliser.
They've just put it into the mixer, haven't they? It's Josh Bash who puts it back and then from the blue line it gets put in and it just gets scrambly. Lord is doing very well to get in the way of Ervin Mustakovs, who's come out very far, and then I think it's Nielsen is also part of that mix, and in it goes. Cardiff Devils back on level terms.
And hang on, Murdy has his helmet on and is off the bench. We're going to see Tom Murdy. Ben Bounds is not going to be able to continue, and what a shame that is. Oh, break opportunity for the Devils. They're going to get a 2-on-1 here. What a chance and what a really good block.
Ben O'Connor's
on the pass
it.
From O'Connor, laying yeah. down and using his stick. Just needed a little more sauce on the pass to get it up and over. Didn't quite happen. Now O'Connor at the other end. Dowd, pass to the side. Oh, it's hot for Armstrong to deal with. Back out into the crease. Real scramble. Knocked home by Damien. The Steelers are back in front with a power play goal.
It's been scrappy, it hasn't been the prettiest power play, but it's Armstrong with the pass, putting it in the mixer, as they say, right in front of Murdy's net, and it just squeezes in front for Debian, just a poke home as it went through Waugh, and Guillaume Debian gets another goal for the Sheffield Steelers, 2-1.
So power play chance for the Devils there, 0-1 so far. That one came in the very early stages of this game. Here's Bentivoglio. Martin's the option down low. Ulmer is waiting in the slot. 1-3-1 is how the Devils set up.
Am I right in thinking this is the first time we've seen their power play tonight?
Oh, it works! Richardson sneaking in and firing home. Unseen, backside, and whacks it in. There's always that option out wide in the circle.
Absolutely.
And the Devils found it, and they've equalised for the second time on the night. Yet again, another terrific Steelers-Cardiff matchup. Steelers back onto it. And we'll try and get the opportunity with Dowd. Save made, rebound put in! Nelson! The Steelers hit right back!
And just like that, the Steelers have got the momentum back. It's just a hopeful shot. He's got a bit of time. It dances off Murdy's gloves. And Nelson's there to take in Robert Dowd's rebound. 3-2.
Anyway,
yes,
there's still a minute and 20 plus to run on the first of the two penalties. 5-on-4 in the Steelers' favour as Valix goes hard into the glass. Keeps the puck on his stick and plays it back to the blue line. Steelers switch D to D and bring Ratchuk into the play. Back with Valdix. Steelers looking for that clear shooting lane. There's no one in front of Murdy at the moment. Now Ferrara finds the screen, and that's enough to make the difference. The shot from Valdix, and Murdy didn't see it, and he certainly didn't stop it.
Yeah, it's a great shot from Valdix, just down and low, and you've called it beautiful here. Ferrara just screens him there, goes through him, and Murdy can't get down quick enough.
Well, it looks as though the cross-checking thing, cross-checking video went up on the
That's
video screen.
Like. It's an interesting call, that.
Oh, the Steelers have scored another! Hammered home by Ben O'Connor. And with 7:41 to go, that might just be enough this time. Net is still empty, Murdy is still gone. The Devils aren't going to give this one up. They want an extra goal, they want something for their wonderful travelling support to cheer. But the Steelers will get onto this. The net is empty. Hotham is back. And he can't block it. And Dowd has sealed it.
Nelson unselfishly finding Dowd to reward him on what has been a man of the match night. Nelson looking up, he's got no intention of finding the back of the net, gives it to Robert Dowd, who buries it. What a night for the pair, and what a great performance from Robert Dowd.
The puck is sent down the ice, and the Sheffield Steelers are winners on a Sunday night. The Cardiff Devils will not be champions tonight. The Sheffield Steelers are going to hold on to their title for just a little bit longer.
After the break, we'll round up all of the weekend's action as we head to Edinburgh and Dundee. That's still to come on Facing Off. Fife Flyers take the relatively short journey across the Forth to take on Edinburgh Capitals, hoping to secure their playoff place.
In a foot race with Johnson and Ferrucci wins it. Paquette comes inside. The redirect in front just didn't go on goal to Fennell. Fennell throws it in, it comes off the right thigh of Yaroslav Hertl, and then are coming together in front. It's in from Fennell. Gets in front. The pressure coming from the Fife Flyers paid off as they go 1-0 ahead.
And a very good start here for the Flyers. It's 4-4, but they're making all the right moves. And here's the chance now for the Caps. Oh! I don't know how the referee didn't call a penalty on that one, to be honest with you. I just don't know how he did.
Yes! It's an equaliser! Yep, great goal, nice passing. 5 seconds left on the penalty for Caps, and the one good thing is there's still a power play to come. 1:08 left on the Flyers, and Caps tie it up at 1-1.
Milan fires this one, it's blocked in front. Milan takes up a good position, the shot coming in. Schaber gets the puck as he comes out the penalty box, goes top shelf. Chase Schaber, as the Flyers come back to 5-on-5, puts it postage stamp past Travis Fullerton, and the Flyers have a lead once again. And then Haynes picks up the loose puck. Haynes up to Ferrucci. Ferrucci will just send this one in, chased by Isaacs up against Hertl. McDougall send this one round. Moore takes the shot. And in front, and the Flyers take a 3-1 lead. The bouncing puck in front, picked up by the Flyers forward, and now low past Travis Fullerton, and James Isaacs puts it into the net.
Yeah, Cap's got, to me, just got. Does he want a round of applause from him? Anyway,
I'm guessing that's James Isaacs' first goal for the Flyers, and that celebration was them throwing the monkey off his back.
I see, indeed, you're probably right.
Moyer, down deep, out in front, Ferrucci sends it back to Haynes. Haynes to Moyer, back to Ferrucci. Sorry, Brooks that was with a shot. Out in front! And the shot coming in for the Fife Flyers on the 5-on-3 puts them 4-1 ahead.
Yeah, as I say, the game's to me now drifting away from the Caps altogether.
Down to Wilgosh to Schultz, to Wilgosh, takes the shot, scramble in front, and comes back to Johnson now. Johnson thinks about the shot, comes wide and in through Ian Schultz. Schultz, the man who's been sitting in the penalty box for so long, comes back and turns this game round.
Well, let's hope he's maybe turned the game round. This could be a big hurrah. They've got 13:53 left in the last period. and it's now 2-4 for Flyers. This would be the comeback of the season. If Cats get 9-8 minutes left, it would be good to see. So we'll wait and see.
Wilgos with a quick shot, and Mason Wilgos pops it behind Shane Owen, and that third goal came.
Yeah, I said to you, old boy, and the goalkeeper, I mean, look at him, he's distraught as well. And now we have a game on our hands.
Shot coming in, and it's in from the Flyers on the power play. And that one at the back door, just getting tipped in front of Travis Fullerton. The Flyers take that 2-goal lead.
Yep, it just shows you can't afford to take penalties nowadays, really. The Caps just get themselves back into the game.
To Vorobyev. Vorobyev outside of Fox. And then across now to Tipoff. Tipoff just couldn't get that puck. And it comes back to Dobrin. Dobrin fires. Goal! Mikael Dobrin! Points, gets this game back to 5-4.
What a good goal from the player coach, and that gets it back to 5-4 in the 3.5 minutes to go. This game is anything but over.